So, welcome to Grandma's Soul Food Shack. Don't be deceived, we're in Chandler at an old spaghetti factory. Throughout the evening, be sure to keep your eyes on all the guests. Even the ones you're sitting with. Someone in this group has killed Mr. Matthews, y'all. Look around. Everybody is a suspect to me. I do nothing but narrate. And I'm here to also tell you that we need to free Britney, just like real quick, if we could collectively go and free her. Free Britney. That is why the police have been called to help locate evidence and determine who had the most to gain by the death of Mr. Matthews. Before we get to that, our story begins with Mr. Matthews' youngest daughter, Elizabeth, and her boyfriend, Percy, who are on their way to Mr. Matthews' house to discuss her relationship and grades.
Man, I hope my dad doesn't give us the third degree again. I was really hoping he'd be more understanding by now.
Look, bro. Your dad has never liked me and he never will. He thinks I'm not good enough for you.
I know things have been hard between you and my dad, but if he got to know the real you, he'd really like you.
He wouldn't give me a chance. That's what happens when you get rich quick and turn your back on your family.
What are you talking about? He hasn't turned his back on anybody. He's always giving vacations, jewelry, cars to everyone that works for him. And he paid for my car.
You drive an old BMW? You should be in a Corvette or Mercedes. Your sisters are living the good life, and he is throwing you his leftovers?
What? Okay, look, at least I have a car. And everywhere we go, you're driving my car. So get it together.
Oh. Yeah, well, he's still treating you like chump change. Every time we pull up to the spot, people be looking at me sideways, stepping out of your ride.
Okay. Get it together. I'm done with you. It's not a crime to be wealthy, and it's not a crime to be rich.
Oh, you are the one that is wrong. You're blind, too. All he does is flaunt his money and jewelry and cars. He probably has 1,000 chicks on the side, too. But he ain't nothing but a trick. And all that sugar daddy.
I don't like the way you're talking about my father. It's not a crime to be wealthy, and it's not a crime to be rich, like I already said.
Right. But it is a crime when you're riding through the hood with your nose up in the air, looking down on people like me. And I'm taller than you, and not everyone was meant for college and working for the man.
He loves this community, and he does a lot to help the youth.
Look, I'm not going to argue with you about your rich pops. Just make sure to ask him for an extra $10,000, you know, something light. I need that money to get my rap video done. Let's see how much he helps the youth. Me?
Okay, I'll call him. He can't rap anyway. Hi, Dad. I'm on the way to the Soul Food Shack. I'm gonna go pick up Percy. Can we get something to eat? Oh, okay. Okay, cool. Okay, I'll talk to you later. I love you. Bye. Okay, I'm coming.
Awesome. All right, well, come get me and give me your keys because I'm driving your car. Isn't technology amazing how you could hear that entire phone call? God, wonderful. Now check this out. 3 days before his death, Bill discovered some shocking information. Oh my God, I'm finding out about this right now as I read it. The news was so shocking, I don't know what that other word meant, that he feared for his life. He hired a private detective. Go Gadget money, am I right? Like, he hired a private detective who provided him with unsavory gossip details about his wife, business partners, family members, and friends. He set up a meeting with his attorney to discuss what he has found and to make changes to his last will and testament. Please include the narrator before you die. Like, I'm just... Nobody? Just me? Okay. Little did he know that in 3 days, his body would be discovered in his kitchen. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. William B.M. Matthews.
Hello, Melissa. Yes, I need to see you as soon as possible. Can you get in like 5 minutes? Okay, great, thank you very much. Oh, I am so ready to expand my business internationally. Life is good. Business is good. I'm on top of my game. And now it's time to reward myself, my family, my friends, and my business partners.
I love it, family. Yes.
Ooh,
I love it.
Oh, I'm waiting for Melissa to get here. I can't wait till she gets here. What is she going to be doing? Window in Melissa. Melissa, come in.
I think I heard a knock.
Come in, Melissa.
Jeez. Mr. Matthews.
Yes.
I came as fast as I could.
Ooh.
Is everything all right?
Yes. Everything is great, Melissa. Everything is great. Oh, I am so ready to expand my business internationally. Oh. And I want to surprise everyone with an all-expense-paid trip to Dubai. Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Dubai?
Dubai. Oh.
You are such a generous man, William.
Stop.
I can't believe it.
Well,
I just hope your family and friends and business partners appreciate what you're doing. Oh, did you sign that latest updated will?
Oh, yes. I signed the lease and I put it in the safe.
Oh, good.
I am just ready to show them how much I love them. You know, it's been a long time that's coming. You know, I have worked really hard to make sure that the Soul Food franchise is successful. This is just a small token of my appreciation for everyone in my life.
Well, I am just very happy for you, William. And I'm happy to be a part of your life.
Oh, you are?
You know, I appreciate you so much.
Oh, no problem. Oh, that must be Tiny. You know, I hired Tiny to check over my investments and look after my business properties to make sure they're secure. And to make sure that my investments are making money.
Yeah. Smart man.
What's up, Tiny?
Hey, Mr. Matthews.
Yes, what's going on? Yes.
Hey, girl. You strong. Oh,
yeah. Melissa, hey, girl.
Hi,
you looking good?
Hi, Tiny.
Hey. Mr. Matthews,
yes.
I have some bad news for you. You may want to sit down for this one.
Well, let me get back to that.
Okay.
Hold on.
I bet it's that new stock that I purchased. You know, I had a feeling that it would be a bad investment.
No, it actually wasn't a bad investment.
No?
I put it overnight, so I'm good.
Maybe it's that warehouse I bought in Avondale, huh? I had a feeling that it would need to make renovations.
No, it's nothing. It wasn't the warehouse. Actually, Amazon's bringing it, now they gotta pay you rent.
Oh, yes,
I'll bet it's that Bitcoin, that stuff you invested in. You know, it really sounds like fake money to me. Just a real scam. Like those Social Security folks that keep calling me about my Social Security number.
No. The Bitcoin stock is actually doing quite well. You should actually consider investing.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
And those Social Security calls are definitely scams, so stop answering the phone. Okay.
Don't answer the phone.
Tiny, you look a little serious. Spill the beans. What did you decide?
Well, Mr. Matthew, it's like this.
What?
You're in danger, man.
What?
Yeah.
No.
It's like that. Yeah, you're in danger. And your whole fortune is at risk.
Oh.
Yeah.
What?
It's crazy too, because when rubber meets the road, it's usually those closest to you that do the most damage. Let me show you what I've been
talking about. Let me see.
Check it out.
I want to see it too.
Oh.
Mm. Yeah,
Tiny.
Mm. Oh, my word.
Oh.
Oh, brilliant. Mm. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Yeah.
What are you going to do?
Well, let's see. Let's keep this information between the three of us, huh? Melissa,
yeah?
Put Detective Wilson on the line.
Oh, okay. Yes. Okay. William, Detective Wilson, he's not answering, but the chief of the precinct, he wants to see you there right away.
Okay, thank you, Melissa.
Sure.
Tiny. Get those files together. Melissa, put the wheel back in the safe. Let's head to the police department and get to the bottom of these things. Walk this way.
Season 2 and back. Amongst Bill's last known wishes, he wanted the reading of his will to be held at the Soul Food Shack. Look at that. Transported you to the Soul Food Shack. Wow. Looks amazing. For an old-fashioned soul train party thrown in his honor, he gave his trusted friend and attorney, Melissa Brownstone, instructions to invite the following people to attend the party. Melissa Brownstone, attorney at law.
All right, Melissa.
Hey, girl. Hey, I made a few changes to Bill's will just days before he was murdered. I tell you, something's wrong. You should have listened to me. I'm good at my job, real good. I should have warned him.
Wow, you can take your seat, though, too. You don't have to go all the way out. It's a party. Come and sit down. Join the book. Order food. The shrimp is great. Linda Matthews, grieving wife and mother to his two daughters, or we don't know, we're not married, who should receive the entire estate.
How y'all doing? First off, y'all, I was going for change. This just happened way too fast. Man.
You probably didn't have time to plan, did you?
I didn't. At all. But I guess I'm qualified in my Shoes Foundation to get his bang. I can finally put my touch back in my house. Once I get back from the house, of course, the black girls just so fun.
Coming up next, we have Alice Bottle, who is a friend to Linda Matthews. Come on in, straight ahead.
Uh-oh.
As straight as possible as you can. If you could just come this way.
Hey, okay. I'm having myself a good old time. Hanging out with my best friend, my rich best friend. Can I get a drink?
Unless you can have water. Coming up next is Ebonique, best friend to Linda Matthews. Such rich.
Wait, girl. I love the life that I've created for myself as an Afrocentric entrepreneur. But I just wish that my friend had the same value in herself and recognized these best friends. Ain't nothing but you.
Yes, come through, JC Penney 97 Cavanaugh. And coming up next, Jennifer Smith, the Event Services Director.
Uh-oh. After working together for 15 years, I know all his business secrets. He taught me well, and I'm damn good at my job. I deserve to be compensated. It's time for me to travel the world and start living my real life.
Coming up next is Miss Jones, the housekeeper for over 20 years. And if you've got like a business card, you can just get it.
I have worked for over 20 years for the Matthews house and for all of the Matthews. You would think that they would service me for all the work that I've done for them.
Alrighty, well, next in line is Roberta Brooks, the
the accountant for 10 years.
Sure, I may have borrowed some money without Bill's knowledge, and some mistakes have been made along the way, but I covered them up. He doesn't even know about it. Does he?
You guys just remember, Roberta looks good because she invested in Bitcoin. Okay?
She didn't invest.
We love a monochromatic queen.
She didn't invest.
Oh, coming up next.
David Matthew Jones, Soul Food Shack manager. Calm down, Dave. David, just this to the center. To the center. Nobody's ordered today. You're under criminal investigation.
Look, man, I don't even know why I'm here.
Under criminal
I don't know why I'm here. I'm not expecting anything. I've only been working at the shack for about a year. Remember when I met Mr. Matthews down at ATL on the job right on the spot? Plus, I don't move this just as bad. Plus, I was coming to Phoenix anyway.
That's a coincidence. Mary Matthew Jones coming up next is the jealous older sister with the faux furry butt.
Whatever. I already know I ain't got nothing coming to me. He just invited me here just to show off. Well, he got what was coming to him anyway. Besides, I don't need nothing from him. 30 bastards.
It's not nice to call people names now. I shop at Savers with Mary too. Coming up next is Dorothy Jackson Matthews, jilted ex-wife who feels entitled to part of her state, straight from Paris Fashion Week in Paris, Texas.
Boo! Boo!
I know. He better have left me something.
Nothing.
Oh, it's going down for real, for real. As the mother of his two kids, fine. I know. He better have that lease on.
Coming up next is Lead Detective Wilson, who leads the investigation. Yeah.
That's right. I cut a few corners. I made a few assumptions.
Here he goes.
But hell, this is gonna be easy. Always follow the money. And I'm good at what I do.
Yes, you are so good that we in fact need Detective Hanson, who's second in charge, to like dot your I's and cross your T's, because sometimes you
just get on my everlasting learning. When will I get the opportunity to prove myself as a detective? I am tired of being the second in charge. I will solve this murder no matter what it takes, and I will be lead detective.
Come on, Hunger Games. Coming up now, speaking of hunger, Mother Spitfire, the cook, is here.
Yes, Mother.
Listen, my princess is very, very unique.
Yes, Mother.
Yeah. And I have seen some unusual things in my day.
Okay.
If you're only new, baby, if you're only new.
Alrighty. In loving memory of William Bill Matthews, today we say goodbye to one of the most prominent members of our community and society who was murdered in his home. This is what happens when you're on psychedelics.
Realism.
William Bill Matthews, also known as BM, was born in Jackson, Mississippi, and grew up on a farm working at his mother's soul food shack. Her entire fortune to her favorite grandson, William Bill Matthews. Even though William had an older sister, she left everything to BM.
William immediately made changes to how the business was ran, and within a few years, he was so successful that he opened a chain of soul food shacks and started an event services company. Within a year, he had doubled his investment. He also had a large jewelry and art collection that was also worth millions. I'm not trying to say anything, but I feel like this man's gonna die. He had a lot of stuff. Now about his death, see, I was right.
Yes.
It was really tragic. It is obvious that he did not commit suicide since he was shot, stabbed, beaten, burned, and robbed. Y'all didn't even let him go to heaven when he died. His watch, wallet, and jewelry were also missing, and his pockets were inside out. This leads investigators and spectators to believe that this was personal, or that there could have been more than one killer, or they have no idea who killed Mr. Matthews, which is why we need your help. Please participate. We have no idea who did it. What? Oh, it's the side chick. No, I typically, well, I don't think it's anything on the side because that man ate full entrees. So I don't. Bill's lawyer. All night, baby, all night. Bill. Could attend the reading of the will. It is possible that one of the guests could be the killer. Ladies and gentlemen, Melissa Brownstone.
Hello, everyone.
Hey, girl.
I welcome you all with great sadness for the reading of the will of William Bill Matthews.
Yes.
I am Melissa Brownstone, William's lawyer and friend for over 15 years. Shortly before he died, Bill came to me to make some drastic changes to his will.
I wonder why.
Well, I'm just glad you're all here tonight for the reading of that will. But we also need you to help us find out who done it.
Oh my God.
Brownstone will now read the will, kind of like expeditiously because the food's coming in, but like, yeah.
The last will and testament of William Bill Matthews.
Mercy, Lord, I can't take your vote.
I, William Bill Matthews, being of sound mind and judgment, do declare this to be my last will and testament.
Yes.
I have been married twice and have four beautiful daughters. However, it was my desire to have a son to carry on my name and be their heir to my estate, but it was not to be. I appoint my lawyer, Melissa Brownstone, as the executor of my will. Here are my final wishes. Linda Matthews, I give you the house, cars, and all personal effects plus $5 million. Move on with your life as you should. I am happy you have Ebony, who is a trustworthy friend, but you should watch out for Alice Bottle and check her motives. Assistant Jennifer, I leave you a retirement pension worth $250,000 and the entire Phoenix Event Services franchise.
Thank you.
You saved me well as my assistant, and you kept all of my secrets. Your home, car, credit cards, and outstanding bills have been paid in full.
Thank you.
Miss Jones, housekeeper. I purchased a condo in Sun City for you to live out the rest of your days very comfortably. You deserve all the best, and I hope that you will forgive me. Mary Matthews, I put money away for you the same day I received my inheritance. I have saved $3.5 million for you.
brother.
A fund. A fund has been set up for you and David. I have always loved you and only wanted your love in return.
I love my brother.
Dorothy Jackson Matthews. I owe you nothing. You made it. You made it.
You made it.
What?
I owe you nothing. You made life for me and my girls a living hell. I have paid off your home, cars, credit cards, and other bills. You have $100,000 line of credit. Spend it wisely, because the train has just left the station.
Sit down.
I gave that sucker my life.
Sit down,
right. Robert Brooks. Roberta Brooks.
Don't touch Roberta.
You helped me make a lot of money. You made me rich, and apparently my wife happy. And thoroughly satisfied. I leave you my share of stock in the Texas Soul Food Shack franchise that's worth $2.5 million. David Matthew Jones. You are promoted to head manager of the Texas Soul Food Shack with a bonus that is double yearly salary. I wish I had the opportunity to teach you more about the business. Wishing you the best of luck. Mother Spitfire.
Yeah. Hold on. Right, girl. Wait a minute.
Hold on.
Okay. You have seen it all.
Yeah.
You've heard it all.
Yeah.
And you know it all.
I do.
When the time is right, please let it all be as we discuss. I leave the remainder of my bank account and estate to you. All the people listed in my will will receive their inheritance contingent on the fact that if I die tragically, then they are not responsible for my death. If anyone is guilty of my demise, they are immediately disinherited. Their portion of my inheritance will be split equally among the rest. Now, if a male heir is found at the time of my death, I would name him the sole heir to my estate. However, no known male exists. These are my final wishes. Sincerely, William Bill Matthews. Information that he knew would change the course of his life and the lives of everyone he knew. He quickly made some last minute changes to his will.
Excuse me, Melissa.
Yes?
This is why I come in.
What?
Look, let me tell you. All y'all suspects in Bill's murder. That's right, all y'all.
Tripping.
Incriminating evidence has been found by my second in charge.
Ex-wife. Ooh. Not the entitlement. And what about someone from this side? Who do you think did it? Who? Oh, the manager. Dang. Dang. Okay. Well, we're right now going to transport you guys right back to the Soul Food Shack. If you still have your whodunit cards, when you're done with them, just go ahead and kind of raise them up in the air and we'll have somebody come around and collect them. Mother Spitfire was just about to reveal who killed Mr. Matthews when the lights went out and they were gunshots. So right back to the Soul Food Shack. Let's see who done it.
Shoot.
All right, stop. Move. Everybody all right?
Yeah.
Don't nobody move. Mother Spitfire, why are you holding that gun? You need to tell me right now who killed BM.
Wait. Mother Spitfire, I strongly advise you, please, don't say anything.
Here she go again.
Without a lawyer present, anything you say could be held against you. And guess what? Detective Wilson there. He is not your friend.
He sure ain't. Well, not at all.
Well, I told y'all I was an eyewitness reporter. I told y'all that a while ago. And I just wanted to let you know what happened. And I was in the kitchen and I was cooking. And all I was doing was just trying to cook me some food.
What were you cooking?
And I heard something in the back. And then, you know what? Where he was. When I looked, I heard the noise. And I looked, and I saw something. It was dark. And it was dark.
Okay.
And he was handsome.
Handsome.
But then I started to smell something.
Uh-oh. Mm.
And that's when I know that it was a man, because it was smelling musky. I knew it was a man. I know.
Did she say musky? Or musty.
Mother Spitfire, you are a hot mess. Are you sniffing out men now?
What? No way. Her nose is too small to sniff out a musky man.
You got a problem with Egyptian musk? I rock it all the time and I get no complaints.
That's your problem.
That's because that Egyptian musk was back in the 70s. It didn't smell good then and it still don't smell good.
It sure ain't.
Mother Spitfire. Did you say musky? Is that an aftershave or a rat?
It must have been husky, right?
Husky.
No.
Are y'all saying that?
Wait a minute.
Musky.
A man is dead and you all are cracking jokes?
Yep.
What's wrong with you people?
He ain't giving me no money. It's funny.
And Mother Spitfire standing there with a gun in her hand. Don't you think that's strange?
No.
Look, everybody just be quiet. Shut up. Hanson, get that gun from Mother Spitfire. Now, Mother Spitfire, we about to get down to the bottom of this investigation. You need to tell me right now exactly what you saw.
What you see, Mother?
Yeah, what you see?
Well, y'all forgive me because y'all know I'm on my medication. Y'all know sometimes I But all I was doing was just trying to cook a meal for my man, Mr. Matthews.
Hmm.
And I heard something in the back door.
That's right.
And all I was doing was minding my own business. And then I heard the noise.
Mm-hmm.
And then I went to pick up my pocketbook. And I went to run toward it.
Get up, Mother!
Who was it?
Who was it? Who did you see?
Well,
look, I'll ask a question around here. What's me for? You need to get on up and tell me what happened here. Come on,
Hanson.
If y'all don't help Mother up.
And
beat the devil out of
you.
Hell!
Oh!
Fire!
Hey!
Fire!
Hey!
Fire! Fire!
Come on,
girl!
Fire!
Go, oh, mama!
Yo, cut it out! Go on, continue, Mother Spitfire.
Ain't no fun.
Yo, diaper showing. She just helping you. Now please continue.
That's all right, Mother. Bloomer season, bloomer season.
After I beat it with the thing, I throw the apron on the stove. I called a Uber and I went home.
That's right.
Because it was all this at that time of the day.
That's right.
If you went home, then
you been crazy.
Where were you at when you were attacked? Here you go. Ain't nobody asked you.
See?
I'm just saying.
See?
I'm just saying.
You know, you was not that smart.
Look, old lady.
As I was saying.
I love it. She
was saying. I was just being pulled away. I
said,
what? I
told
y'all this medication got me mad.
That's right. That's right, Mother. It's okay.
The doctor put me on it. I don't know what's going on.
Listen, I am tired. Have a seat.
Take your time, Mother.
Have a seat.
I'm just trying to tell y'all
what happened. I don't want to hurt you. Uh-oh. Have a seat.
Hansen, get back. What are you doing? What are you doing?
Listen, boy, your time is up. I know who killed
Mr. Matthew.
Wait
a minute. Wait a minute.
And I'm going to solve it now.
Wait. I smell it.
You smell it?
Smell
it? Smell it?
I'm smelling what I smelled that day.
Is it musky?
So this is what happened. Now, Mr. Williams asked me to do a background check on David Matthews. David Jones, that boy right there. Because he kind of thought that he might have been his son. So I was able to obtain David Jones' DNA. And you are his son. Now the thing of it was,
I knew that boy looked familiar.
Who was David's mother?
I ain't his mother.
That's what I had to figure out.
Who is the mother? I knew it. I knew he looked familiar.
Okay.
What? Woo!
Oh, it ain't the rain.
You? I am David's mother.
Oh my God.
Wait a minute. It was a long time ago before when Ben and I were dating, before he received this inheritance. I was young and I was struggling.
That's why he left all that money.
Just when he got his inheritance, he was consumed with the life changes. I didn't want to hold him down, so when he asked me if the baby was his, I lied. Sorry, son.
I lied.
And so I was young and I was struggling.
You knew.
So all this time, you've been walking around the shack. Every day, not saying nothing, didn't mention anything to me.
Didn't want to hold back.
No, nothing.
Hey, they said my mama was from Phoenix and my dad was unknown.
Uh-huh.
And my mom couldn't take care of me. But you know what? Been looking for you, mama. Mama, I've been looking for you.
Lord. Aww.
Praise the Lord.
to know who killed my brother.
You don't care.
Excuse me, Mother Spitfire.
Okay.
You need to tell me who you saw or you smelled killed B.M.
I'm smelling it right now. I recognize your smell.
Well, come on, Mother.
I smell it.
You're the one. Okay, so I was there. You're the one. Stop it. First of all, I was there, but I had some files to give
BM.
Now,
I
was working undercover, and I knew that he knew that his accountant, Robertus Brooks, was putting money in offshore accounts. So I was coming there to uncover that. And he was overcome with emotion, and he finally knew the truth that Ms. Jones came out with. And I located David and Mr. Matthews and hired him to work for him.
Uh-huh.
So that was it.
Okay. Hanson.
What?
You need to tell me why were you at his house the night of the murder.
Because I had the files he requested. I was going to tell him that I was in love with him.
What?
Why? Somebody else?
You were in love with my man, girl.
You can't have it. So Mother Spitfire showed up, and I just left out the back door. I was at the office when the call came in that BM was killed.
You all right, just me. Hold up. Hold up. Mm-mm. Everybody just hold up. God damn it. Let me recap my investigation.
Go ahead.
So y'all can listen. Y'all need to listen.
All right, then.
Okay. Let me see. Melissa Brownstone.
Yes.
Yeah, that's you. I got that you made some changes to Bill's will a few days before he was murdered, right?
Yeah.
Some of them changes he did not request. What's really going on? Huh? Mm-hmm. Linda Matthews.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Linda Matthews.
On record.
Up.
You couldn't wait for the death certificate.
Couldn't wait.
And a few changes to Bill's will. You were packing up Bill's stuff before he was married. Your two daughters may not be his. That's right. What's really going on?
They are here.
Alice Bonner. You call yourself a friend of Linda, but you only hung around her because of the money.
That's right. That's right.
Ebony, you know, I did a little research on you. You know, you're a good friend of Linda.
That's right.
But your lack of patience without his father is harsh and it's too relentless. Jennifer Smith.
What?
Let me tell you something. You hold many secrets, girl.
I told you I
Yeah, you do.
Yo,
after working with BM for the past 15 years, how in the hell did your salary increase by $200,000 a year?
Hey,
that's very suspicious.
That's a lot of secrets.
That's a lot of secrets.
You ain't got to explain it, sis.
Miss Jones. Miss Jones, look at her. You, let me tell you something. All this time, you knew BM had a son. You knew you had a son.
Yes, you did.
Yeah, you did. And you kept quiet until a year ago. That put you on the top of the list of my suspects.
Yeah.
Roberta Brooks.
All right, Roberta.
Real crook.
20 years with BM. 10 years. You borrowed money without his knowledge. Yeah, you stole it.
Oh,
yeah, you did.
Yeah,
you did.
Yeah.
You open offshore accounts?
Huh.
I got them right here. That puts you on the top of my suspect list.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Don't worry about this. I'm detecting.
Oh,
let me detect. David Matthew Jones. Let me tell you something, man.
He didn't kill his daddy.
BM offered you a job. You took it as general manager. But you ain't had no experience. Yet. You took the job.
He did.
Why would you leave in life and come to Arizona to a job you had no experience with? I'll get back to you later.
Man, don't work, don't eat. You gotta do something.
My daddy now.
What's your daddy?
Now. Okay. Now.
Huh.
So that's all I got.
Mary Matthews.
Oh, Mary. Oh, yes, Mary.
Uh-oh.
Mary.
Working overtime.
Mary Matthews. She ain't in my script right now. Mary Matthews, that was your brother. I don't have
him. Treated him so bad.
Somebody took it out my wheel.
You treated him real bad, man.
Yeah, you treat your brother real bad, man.
And he took care of
you. And he took care of your ass. So that makes you a suspect, too.
Yeah, I
did. You did it.
Dorothy Matthews.
What?
You were the jealous ex-wife.
Mm-hmm. Jealous?
Of being.
No money.
Was
she jealous?
Some of them kids, man, they need to be
gone. Mind your business.
They not.
You wanted more money, he wouldn't give you none.
Mm-hmm.
You on my top of my list, too.
Mind your business.
Oh, hang it up your list.
Mind your business.
Mother Spitfire. Look, you've been with DM all his life. All his life.
He served him well.
And you served him well. I got it. You served him well. I got it. But, I don't know.
Listen here, Wilson.
What?
I have final information to present.
Well, go ahead, Hanson. I'm tired of you. Will you come on?
Anyway, was notified by BM's private investigator, Tiny, who's going to present his will, along with his longtime caretaker, Nurse Hatchett.
Let me get ready.
Okay.
With them there. Thank you. That's what I need right there. Right there. Mm-hmm.
There he is.
You know, Mr. Tiny, you know, BM was my pet name for William. BM was the best thing that ever happened to me.
Mm-hmm. You too?
You know? Yeah, me too. And poor guy, he... I can't believe that someone in this group... killed BM.
Shame on you!
Yeah.
Reason made some of y'all lose y'all mind.
Whoa.
Okay? Yeah. You should have kicked y'all.
What y'all doing?
To the curb a long time ago.
You gonna use that gun if you gonna point
especially
it.
Especially you.
Oh my goodness.
You alright then?
I'm alright, baby.
Okay.
So, you know, BM was so handsome.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, just look at this gorgeous face.
Yeah.
And he always looked out for the best in everyone.
Yes.
You know, he convinced me to quit my job at the club as head stripper.
Woo! All right now!
Yeah, and he was one of the best too.
Okay.
He was one of the best. And he gonna be missed.
Yes.
Now yes. BM changed his will hours before his murder. You can go ahead and have a seat. You look very good. So I'm gonna present the new will.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
It's okay, baby girl.
So Melissa Brownstone,
yes.
Do you mind reading the new final will and testament for William B. and Matthews?
Another will? Another.
Okay, you better hope you got some.
All right.
I hope it didn't take you out.
Updated. This is the updated last will and testament of William Bill Matthews. I, William Bill Matthews, being of sound mind and judgment, do declare this to be my updated and final will and testament. I revoke all other wills as of today. These are my final wishes.
Uh-oh.
Linda Matthews, I know all about your affair with my event services assistant, Jennifer Smith.
What?
I also had DNA testing done on the girls and discovered that none of them are mine.
See? I told you.
I have set up a $5 million trust fund through Finding My Shoes Foundation for the girls, in which you have no rights to. You get $100,000 and the townhouse. And you have 30 days to evict the property.
She can evict us on
30 days.
Assistant, Jennifer.
Yes.
I discovered you were having an affair with my wife.
It wasn't like that.
I felt wrong, deceived, and disrespected. I will allow you to keep your position as director and a salary of only $125,000.
That's not fair.
Miss Jones, housekeeper, I always suspected that you were carrying my child. I understand why you made the choice to hide my son from me. Your portion of the will has not changed. A $10 million trust fund has been set up for you. Mary Matthews, we wasted so much time not speaking. Your inheritance will remain the same.
Hallelujah!
I have saved $3.5 million for you. I love you, sis.
I love you, brother.
Dorothy Jackson Matthews.
Yeah, get over on. Get over.
I owe you nothing. You cheated throughout our entire marriage. I have set up counseling and therapy for you. It's a 6-month program. Once completed, you will then obtain your $100,000 credit line of business credit. And because of our children, I paid off your home, cars, credit cards, and all other bills. You are on your own.
Oh, man.
Robert Brooks.
Roberta. Thank you.
I'm Roberta Brooks. I am unable to have trustworthy people on my team. I revoke your shares of stock in the Texas Soul Food Shack franchise. I will, however, provide scholarships opportunities for your boys through the Finding My Shoes Scholarship Foundation. David Matthew Jones.
Yes.
I can't begin to tell you how happy I was to find out that you were my son. I only wished that I had known earlier and had been a part of your life. I want you to take over as co-owner of the Soul Food Shack empire with my trusted attorney, Melissa Brownstone, and $25 million. Wishing you the best of luck, son.
Boy, you better get some money.
Mother Spitfire. I want the world to know that you are my beloved mother.
What?
And I leave you $20 million.
Yes.
But
yes, mother.
You are still holding. You're still
holding yes,
some
mother.
Secrets. These are my final wishes.
Yes, mother! That's your grandma.
Pick her up, y'all.
Mother, let me hold some money.
Nurse Hatchett, thank you for your service. I purchased Barbie's Dancing Dolls Club for you, valued at $1 million. Please do not ever dance or strip again. Please. Tiny, thank you for your service.
Tiny.
You are now the owner of Matthews Security Firm worth $5.5 million.
Yes!
Please take care and take my advice and avoid Dorothy like the plague.
Yeah. I'm gonna holler at you in a minute.
All right. So now, just hold up. I have solved the murder. Due to all the incriminating evidence, eyewitness testimony, I'm about to file first-degree murder charges.
On who?
Mother Spitfire, get
up! What?
Let me tell you something.
He is wrong.
You need, look, let me tell you something.
I didn't know it.
On the night in question, you was at BM's house.
Ooh.
That's right. You stabbed him 29
His
times.
His own mother.
You kicked him. You robbed him. Your own son. And you hit him with a rolling pin about 57 times. Then you tried to cover up the murder by trying to burn him. How could you, Mother Spitfire?
Mother!
You killed your own son! Turn around, Mother Spitfire. Put your hands behind your back. Put your hands behind your back. Put your hands behind your back.
You're wrong!
Put your hands behind your back. Hey, I don't
have... Wait a minute!
I don't have enough of you, old lady. Turn around!
Hold up, hold up, hold up, hold up, hold up, hold up, hold up.
It's your mother.
Y'all didn't... Wait a minute, really quick. Who out there in the audience thought it was Mother Spitfire? Show of hands. Raise your hand. We got one person. We got one detective in here. There's a room full of like 600. Y'all. Two, three. See, y'all come and start coming out of the woodwork. See, picking on Mother Spitfire would have been too easy. So let's see what happens next.
All right, Mother Spitfire, I don't have enough of you, old lady. I don't have enough. Turn around. Put your hands behind your back. Put your hands behind your back. Come on, I had enough of you, old lady.
That the files that I had some other information in it. Not only did it have David's birth certificate, but it also had another one. So, is there another brother around here? Wilson? Or should I say, Wilson Matthews?
Uh-huh. Wait a minute!
We found out that he was a stepbrother, my half-brother.
Uh-huh.
And I went to call him. And I wanted to let him know.
I knew he did.
But he already knew. Mm-hmm. So I didn't want to run into my chief, tell him everything. So I just didn't need to be done.
But he did.
But
so you under arrest for the murder of your brother William B. and Matthew.
Oh, and you have no place to be.
I make it my business to know y'all's business.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And I'm getting ready to tell y'all who the real killer is.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I was waiting for my theme song. Like every week, reporter has theme music, don't they? Oh,
I like this song.
Hey.
Y'all, look at BM's killer. Alice Bottle.
Oh, no.
where the body was found.
Yes.
Ooh. Yes.
Uh-huh. I was hungry.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, got me a piece of that good old chicken. That smells so good. I took me a bite of that half burned, half raw chicken and upset my stomach.
What?
Okay.
Okay.
And I fucked.
What? So wait, is that when you poisoned him?
Poisoned?
Yes. The autopsy report here says that Mr. Wilson died of gas poisoning.
What? Oh,
God.
Oh,
God.
Oh, my God.
No, not gas poisoning. I told you I fought it. And Mr. Matthew started walking towards me with his big old self. And he was choking me. Gasping for air and fell dead to the floor. And you know what I did?
What?
I went home. I went to sleep. Because I had to go to work for that.
Oh! 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 I am so mad!
And they all lived happily ever after. Rich after just a little bit. What a twist though. I never actually saw that. Just kidding, I've had the script the whole time. I knew who it was. Ladies and gentlemen, the cast of Murder of a Boss. Elizabeth Matthews played by Tamia. Attorney at Law Melissa Brownstone played by Bobby Bennett. Linda Matthews, wife of BM, played by Erica. Alice Bottle, friend to Linda Matthews, played by Yvette. Ebonique, best friend to Linda Matthews, played by Anita Michelle. Jennifer Smith, event services director, played by Monica. Housekeeper Mrs. Jones, played by Tanya. Yeah, yeah. Soul Food Shack manager David Matthews Jones, played by Frank. Jealous older sister Mary Matthews, played by Beverly Brown. The accountant Roberta Brooks, played by Tatiana. The jilted ex-wife, Dorothy Matthews, played by Billy Grant. Lead Detective Wilson, played by Seth Easy-Smith. And he's so good, we just had to have a second detective in charge, played by Miguel Blake. Nurse Hatchet, played by the one and only Deanna Taylor. And you know, Tiny was a pretty big role to play, and it was only fulfilled by Tyrone Big Baby Cook, Mother Spitfire, played by Kimberly Smith. Mr. William B.M. Matthews, played by Corey Harden. Ladies and gentlemen, I am your narrator, host, and the voice of Percy, Nino Daniel. Coming up to the stage for some closing statements is our writer, producer, and director, also the player of We Vet, Dr. Brenda Combs.
Hey, y'all. Hey, y'all. Thank y'all so much for coming out tonight. My name is Dr. Brenda Combs. I am the ambassador of inspiration. I'm writer, producer, director, publisher. I run sober living homes with my husband. I want to take a moment and share with y'all a little bit of our story and why we do these plays. Tony, can you come up here, please? Mayor, Mr. Mark Tony Carter. Tony and I used to be homeless. I was homeless for 10 years. I used to live underneath the 7th Avenue Bridge in downtown Phoenix. In the time that I was homeless, I was shot, raped, stabbed, burned with cigarettes, hit by a car, overdosed. Of course I tried to commit suicide because I didn't love myself. And my whole life changed one day when I woke up in an alley and someone had stolen the shoes off of my feet as a homeless woman. In 115 degree heat, I walked a mile to the park. And when I got to the park, I fell on my knees and I said, you know what, God, I can't do this anymore. I don't want to be homeless and I don't want to be a drug addict anymore. Now keep in mind, I've been in 13 different programs, but I was still a homeless drug addict. And that day, when someone stole my feet and I fell on my knees and I said, Lord, take it away, instantly I could feel a cool breeze blowing on my skin. And that was the voice of God saying, yes. I hear you, Brenda, I got you. And we're gonna get through this together.
Yes.
And I met Tony in the park under the bridge. He had been homeless for 20 years. And the Lord brought us together. And to make a long story short, I was attending school. I realized that I was not going to be successful in the world because the world doesn't like people like me because I have a record. I'm black. I used to be a drug addict. I was homeless. People don't trust me just because of that. So it was going to be a difficult journey. I knew then I needed to go to school to get an education, because an education is what it was going to take to give me choices, options, and opportunities. And before I was able to go to school, I had a baby. And my baby suffered a massive stroke at birth. He was paralyzed, he couldn't swallow. The doctors had no hope for him to live a good life. And so I knew then I was going to be his first teacher. And I went back to school and I got my undergrad in human services in 2 years. I enrolled at Grand Canyon University in the master's program and completed my master's, a 3-year program. I completed it in 1 year. Because I knew then that my life was no longer about me, but about others. And I met Tony in the park, and Tony wanted to change his life. And by this time, he had gotten clean and had gotten himself together. And my life changed after I completed my master's. I was honored by former First Lady Laura Bush naming me Distinguished Teacher of the Year. I was on CNN about a week later where they presented me with a full ride scholarship. I was a CNN Unsung Hero of the Year. And then I was on the Today Show. I did Oprah, radio a couple times. And then Tony and I got married and decided I was going to go into a doctoral program. I mean, who does that? And two former homeless drug addicts got to graduate together. Completing my doctorate in organizational leadership with an emphasis in education, and he completed his master's. And I tell y'all, I brag about it because two former homeless drug addicts with a total of 30 years of addiction getting higher level degrees.
Come on.
This was me when I didn't have an education. This was me when I didn't believe in myself. This is me because today I love myself. That little boy that had the stroke that the doctor said weren't gonna make it. Come here, Michael.
Woo!
Michael. Michael is 21 years old. He is in college. He plays basketball, and he's an entrepreneur, and he is on his way to be successful. And the Lord told me that Michael wasn't enough. Michael has a heart like me. He likes to help the homeless. And one by one, he brought four homeless teenagers home, and I became a bonus mom. And another one is here. Come here, Raul. Raul is from Ethiopia, and he decided he wanted to get into the media, and I bought him his first camera. He works for me. He got a job. Who are you filming for now?
Raymond Callis.
In here.
Raymond Callis.
Raymond Kellis. He's filming now for a basketball team. Yeah. And I just wanted to share that with y'all because I want y'all to know when you leave here and you go back to your communities and your families to let them know that nothing is impossible. You can beat the odds. Everyone in here, you have what it takes to make your goals and dreams become a reality. It may be hard, you're gonna make mistakes, you're gonna fall, but every day that the Lord gives you that breath, you wake up, you pull your boots on, and you head out into the world with a positive attitude. And I promise you that if you learn about the gifts of love and forgiveness, my God, everything that you want to do is going to come true.
Amen. Yes.
Tony and I decided that we were going to start sober living homes because we know what it's like to be homeless, to be hungry, and to be without. And today we are the owner of 5 sober living homes for women and for men. And I share that because I want to let y'all know, I know that everyone in here has visions and goals and dreams and aspirations. And I challenge and charge you right now tonight to do whatever it takes. Yeah. Don't use age as an excuse. I'm too old. I'm 59 years old. Age cannot stop me. Don't let money be the reason, because money comes and goes. You can make money. But what you don't want to do is short yourself, because you deserve it. And you don't know who's watching you and who's going to learn from you and who's going to grow from you. And you can have total peace and happiness making your goals come true.
Yes.
So I charge y'all tonight to live your life with love and forgiveness and compassion.
Amen.
And help your community, because together we will change the world with love and forgiveness.
Yes.
I thank you all for coming tonight. I just want to say that tonight's performance was dedicated to my beautiful sister Karen. We call her Hollywood. She passed Friday night. And we're doing this in her honor. And this is her right here. And I'm telling you right now, she is so happy, because we joke how God must think that I'm a shero, because 3 of my murder mystery plays before I had to perform, my father passed away of cancer and he made me go do the play. My pops passed away of cancer while I was doing Murder of a Boss. Soki, Dr. Soki, my spiritual mother, also passed away of cancer while doing Murder of a Boss. And my beloved Karen went to be with Jesus Friday night. And as much as my heart hurts, I'm not grieving, because she knows she's with the Lord and she has family that loves her. And tonight was dedicated in her honor. And I want to present Mama Sue and her daughter Charisma. My baby, I love you. Aww. And Mama Sue was a mother to my sister Karen. I love you. Thank y'all so much. Now, we have 5 winners, right?
Yeah.
Okay, we have 5 winners who figured out it was Alice Bottle. And I'll read the names off, and Carista has gifts for you for the five winners. And then we have a birthday. Whose birthday is it?
Marty White.
Marty?
Happy birthday, Marty.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Marty. I hope I said it right. Happy birthday to you. Okay, the first winner that guessed Alice Bottle is Ray. Okay, the next person is, I hope I say this right, Sakura. Oh, go get your gift. The next person was Sharice King. Well, y'all was keen on Alice Bottle. The next one is Larry. Larry? My name is Larry.
Go Ray. Go Ray.
And the last one is, well, I don't know who
it is.
On the back it says drunk best friend, and I think it says BW. I don't know who that is. Well, the clue that it was Alice Bottle was in the very first scene when she was in the will. Why would the drunk friend be in the will?
Exactly.
She did it. All right. Okay. All right. All right. So we've got the last winner. All right, y'all. Next month, we will be doing another play called Cancer Calls, and it will be here at the Spaghetti Factory, and I'll be posting about it online. I want to thank everyone for coming out tonight. Thank you for your support of supporting this amazing cast. Let's give it up for the cast one more time. All right, y'all. Thank y'all so much. Be safe and have a good night.